Capernaum is one of the most moving films I've ever seen, due in no small part to the brilliant actors and Nadine Labaki's subtle direction. Labaki's film follows the lives of children and refugees in the slums of Lebanon, and it is handled with a raw yet delicate hand. In this video, I'll be looking at the elements of Labaki's direction which make the film as stunning and touching as it is. The most striking and obvious element that makes Capernaum work so well is the acting. Nadine Labaki is known for primarily working with non-professional actors and even non-actors. She says that normal people deserve to be on the big screen, feeling that this anti-classical method of filmmaking can be more organic. Labaki used real-life characters in similar situations to the characters in Capernaum. For the role of the protagonist, she cast a 12-year-old Syrian refugee, Zain al-Rafia, who had grown up in the slums of Beirut. For the role of Rahil, an illegal immigrant, she cast Yordanos Shifaro, an immigrant from Eritrea who was actually arrested during filming. Labaki's use of non-actors as a way to bring the story closer to reality blurs the boundaries of fiction and non-fiction. The fictional Zain goes through many struggles that the actor Zain went through in real life. When asked about acting, Zain al-Rafia replied that he found acting to be easy. And look at those eyes. That there is no acting. That there is truth. These powerhouse performances are the strongest element at work in this film. However, perfectly complementing the actors is the cinematic choices that Nadine Labaki makes, which elevate these performances. One of which is Labaki's use of shallow focus to isolate characters. As opposed to deep focus, shallow focus results in the depth of field being shallow, making the subject the focus, while the background appears blurred. This is often used to portray a character's isolation. Capernaum uses this liberally not only to show the character's loneliness, but also the otherness they feel around their surroundings. Talking about the purpose of the film, Nadine said, "For me, it was a duty to talk about this subject, to try to see the world from their point of view, to try to understand how they see it." Often in the film, the characters feel they are not a part of the so-called society that has rejected them. They are the forgotten, the outcasts. The shallow focus acts as a visual representation of how they perceive their surroundings as removed from themselves, as apart from themselves. Having worked on documentary films in the past, Labaki conducted an extensive research for 4 whole years for Capernaum. She often spends years on researching and casting for films and immerses herself in the lives of her subjects. About Capernaum, she said, "We used to go and spend hours and hours in those very difficult neighborhoods, talking to people, going from one NGO to the other, talking to judges and lawyers, spending time in court, going to prisons, going to every single corner of these belts of misery that surrounds our cities and our lives." The shoots were done in real locations, slums, sewers, and so on, with the actors being almost real-life counterparts of their characters. All of this feeds into the realism that is apparent in the film. Further, she gave minimal direction to her actors and encouraged improvisation, as such the actors aren't as much acting as being in the moment, prompting truer reactions and a more faithful portrait of people in general. However, here again, Labaki's choices with the camera itself amplify the realism in the film. In my video on what I call cinematic awareness, I talk about cinematic grammar and how cinematic choices in a film often make a viewer anticipate the film itself. A viewer expects a brightly lit scene, for example, to be about lighter subjects, and darker scenes to be more grim. Cinematic grammar has made the audience accustomed to the idea that a fictional film is more staged and professional than a handheld film. A documentary-styled film subconsciously makes us think that whatever is happening is more real than a more staged scene. The film utilizes elements of the documentary style, such as a freer handheld approach, subdued acting, along with frequent ellipses and smash cuts. What this approach also ends up achieving is making the viewer subconsciously relate Capernaum to actual documentary films, since its grammar is closer to documentaries than fictional films. The editing and shot selection are also stripped down to the bare bones, raw, magnifying this effect. Interestingly, while doing this, Labaki never actually breaks the fourth wall, nor uses the now common talking heads approach that faux documentaries and mockumentaries take. What this does is make us consciously keep our suspension of disbelief while subconsciously making us think of documentaries. Since she never calls attention to the fact that she's borrowing visual grammar from documentaries, say by doing a fourth wall break, we never actually notice this. Unlike in the case of, let's say, This is Spinal Tap. Therefore, the effect is more subconscious and therefore more powerful. Now, the film also uses a high number of smash cuts and ellipses. An ellipsis is a narrative device where a certain portion of a sequence of events is omitted, allowing the viewer to infer what happened in between. This is usually done to save on time and avoid over-explaining things to the audience. Smash cuts are used to abruptly end a scene and start another. The reason for using these in Capernaum seems standard enough. The original cut of the film was 14 hours long, because they shot some 600 hours of footage with loads of improvisations, so Labaki used these methods to cut down the film to its final runtime of 150 minutes. However, it is what she cuts out that stands out for me. A standard film is constructed around the idea of tension, with scenes revolving around increasing and decreasing tension. However, Capernaum often seems uninterested in following this tension-based structure. Labaki states that she wanted to shock the viewer. But the shock doesn't come from manipulation or melodrama, but rather the stripped-away approach of Labaki's direction. That is to say, the shock is the rawness of it all. The camera often lingers on characters to allow us the time to fully take in the situation. In this example, Rahil is considering whether to take Zain to her house or not. She can't afford to, she herself is an immigrant. However, she feels for the boy. And then immediately after, an ellipsis. Here again, the camera lingers on Zain making a decision. And here again. These examples by themselves are important in slowing down the pace of the film. Thus, not only letting the film breathe, but letting the audience know that they are not being shown a tightly structured film created for their entertainment. But these examples stand out more with the knowledge that Labaki had 600 hours of material to work with, and she made a very conscious choice to keep these moments in, while removing others. Often people say good films have tension, almost always in the context of keeping the audience interested, or even keeping the audience entertained. If the audience is not entertained, they will not watch the film, or in our case, the video, any longer. And if there is tension, their interest will stay.
Are you not entertained?
As such, the emphasis is put on the entertainment of the viewer, rather than a true exploration of the subject matter. However, Capernaum, with such scenes, seems to stand up to the viewer and say, "No, I will not entertain you." The film relates a human story and stays as true to the characters as possible. Nadine Labaki's ample research and documentary methods are testament to the fact that first and foremost, she wanted to create a film that highlighted the issues she saw around her all the time. Not a film that existed merely to entertain the audience. Tension at times is treated almost with hostility. Labaki's camera seems to scream at the audience, "Look, absorb, take it in." This is how these characters actually live. These various subtle choices aid in creating a true juggernaut of a film that breaks your heart again and again and again. And in my opinion, the entire team of Capernaum deserves all the acclaim they have received. If you like to see more film analysis and video essays, remember to subscribe. If you like the video, please do like and share.